The pill, the patch, the ring, the shot, the implant, IUDs, condoms, diaphragms, cervical caps, sterilization, spermicides, withdrawal, fertility awareness, abstinence. Oh boy, that's a lot of different ways to prevent pregnancy. Let's talk about birth control. Hi everyone, my name is Sarah and welcome back to Everyday Consent. We've talked in previous videos about how informed consensual sex generally involves discussing sexual risks with your partners, as well as some ways to make those conversations a little bit easier. If you are having sex that could lead to pregnancy, namely penis and vagina sex, and you and your partner don't want to get pregnant, then that risk discussion should probably involve talking about contraception or birth control. But many people don't actually know very much about the different birth control methods out there, and so don't know which method would be best for them and their partner. Maybe you're one of those people yourself. Even if you're already using birth control, do you know how effective that method is, or if you're using it correctly? Do you know if it's the best method available to fit your life and your needs? If your partner is the one using birth control, do you know what they're using, or how effective that method is, or if they're using it correctly? For the next two videos, I want to give you some basic information and resources to help you answer these questions, which will hopefully help you have some productive conversations about contraception with your partners. By the way, I'm mostly focusing on the United States and what's approved for use here by the FDA. While a lot of it is similar everywhere, available methods do differ slightly in different countries. So what I say may not be fully accurate for you if you live outside the US. Also, there's a lot to cover with this, which is why I split it into two videos. I'm gonna try to stick with the basics today, and there's more info in the description. But I will be throwing a lot of information at you pretty quickly, so be prepared. Today I'll list the different methods roughly in order of effectiveness. Note that all of these methods are effective. That means that they are all significantly more likely to prevent pregnancy than leaving things up to chance and having penis and vagina sex with no contraceptive method at all. But there is still a difference in effectiveness, so I'm going to group them into three categories: extremely effective, very effective, and effective. I'll also show their effectiveness rate as a percentage on the screen. If there are two percentages on the screen, that means that the effectiveness rate for typical use is different from perfect use, and I've included both. I'll talk more about what that difference means next week. Also next week, I'll talk about many of the other factors that go into deciding among these methods besides effectiveness. In our extremely effective category, we of course have abstinence, which means not having penis and vagina sex at all. Next in this category, we have different forms of permanent contraception, or sterilization, which are generally not reversible if you decide you want to get pregnant later on. A vasectomy is a surgery which involves cutting the vas deferens of someone with a penis so that sperm no longer exits the body during ejaculation. Tubal ligation and tubal occlusion are procedures which cut or block the fallopian tubes of someone with a uterus to prevent an egg from being fertilized or from reaching the uterus. All of the other birth control methods I'll discuss are reversible, which means that you can just stop using them if you want to try to get pregnant. Some reversible methods are still in the extremely effective category. The implant, brand name Implanon or Nexplanon, is a small plastic rod that is inserted under the skin in someone's arm between the bicep and tricep. The implant secretes small amounts of the hormone progestin into the bloodstream and lasts up to 3 years. IUDs, or intrauterine devices, are small T-shaped objects made of mostly plastic that sit inside the uterus. Hormonal IUDs such as Mirena, Skyla, and Lilletta secrete small amounts of progestin into the uterus itself rather than the bloodstream and can last up to 5 years. The copper IUD, brand name Paragard, does not secrete hormones but instead makes use of some of the chemical properties of copper to prevent pregnancy for up to 10 years. Next, we have our very effective methods. The shot, or Depo-Provera, is an injection of the hormone progesterone given every 3 months. The method you're most likely to have heard of if you live in the United States is the pill, or oral contraception. There are many different versions of the pill, some of which contain both estrogen and progestin, and some of which only contain progestin. For all of these, the person taking it swallows a single small pill every day. The patch, brand name Ortho-Evra or Xulane, is a small sticky patch placed on the skin for a week at a time that releases estrogen and progestin. The ring, brand name Nuva Ring, is a flexible ring placed inside the vagina for 3 weeks at a time and also releases estrogen and progestin. Breastfeeding can also be used as a very effective method called lactational amenorrhea, but it is temporary and can only be used in the first 6 months after pregnancy. Now we move on to effective methods. These first few effective methods are all barriers used to block sperm from entering the uterus, and they must be put in place every time someone has penis and vagina sex. The most well-known barrier method is the condom, which is made out of latex or other stretchy materials and is put over the penis. The internal condom is another stretchy barrier made of nitrile and is placed inside the vagina. Diaphragms and cervical caps are reusable barriers requiring a prescription that are placed inside the vagina covering the cervix. The sponge, or today sponge, is also a barrier covering the cervix but does not require a prescription. These last few methods are usually used with spermicides, which are jellies, creams, films, and foams that are placed inside the vagina and kill sperm. The next few effective methods are not barrier methods. Fertility awareness refers to a variety of methods used to predict ovulation by counting cycle days and monitoring things like cervical mucus and body temperature. These methods require avoiding penis and vagina sex during the days conception is most likely to occur. Withdrawal, also known as pulling out or coitus interruptus if you're feeling fancy, refers to removing the penis from the vagina before ejaculation occurs. There are also emergency contraception methods which are used after unprotected sex has already occurred to prevent fertilization. Emergency contraception comes in pill form like Plan B or Ella, or the copper IUD mentioned earlier can also be used as emergency contraception. It's worth noting that emergency contraception pills are very different from the abortion pill and will not cause an abortion. And in the category of not effective, we have no method, which means having penis and vagina sex and not using any method to prevent pregnancy, otherwise known as winging it. There are also a variety of reversible contraceptive methods for people with penises currently being researched, often referred to as male contraception or birth control for men. But none of them are currently approved in the US. Cool, so those are all the methods currently available in the US. And next week I'll go over some of the factors that people might consider when choosing a method, including why effectiveness of a method might not actually be someone's first priority. Tune in next week to find out more. Leave a comment below if there's anything in particular you'd like to hear about, or you can always email me at everydayconsent@gmail.com. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, and if you want to see more from me, don't forget to subscribe. Happy consenting, folks. I'll see you next week. Which will hopefully help.